Hey there. I'm about to do my 8-minute routine, so I thought I would record it and put it online so you guys can see how I do it and follow along if you want. I've got a Tabata timer app that does it, but you can just use a timer on your phone or look at the clock and do a minute for each of the different rounds. And I'm going to put on some music, and the Tabata timer should be going off in just a second, and we'll do this. And so, it'll be interesting because I haven't recorded this before, so just follow along once this goes off. Okay, so I start off with 20 seconds of abs, and I just vary it. I don't have anything exact that I do. So I just do some crunches. Sometimes I do some of a hollow position. Next is the posture and positive affirmations. So I actually usually look in a mirror when I'm doing this, but I have the camera so I can do it here. So I just try to have good posture, shoulders down and back, head lifted tall, and smile at myself in the mirror. I'm actually looking at a shower. And I tend to do calf raises at the same time when I'm doing this. And then I tell myself, good job for doing this. You could be doing something else right now, not productive, but you're doing this and it's making yourself better. And you're a good person and you can do good things and just be happy that you're doing something good for yourself. You can do whatever you want, but it's just supposed to be good posture and just positive self-affirmations. Tell yourself that today's going to be a good day. Okay, next is, I think, I do a handstand. So, you can do whatever you want during this time. It's a kind of a talent or a skill. This is hard to talk for you at the same time. Usually I can hold it pretty steady for a minute. So you can practice piano skills, you can sing skills, you can dance around for a minute, you can juggle, just kind of any skill or talent that you want to develop. It might be something cool that someone else does and you see that you're like, I want to learn that. So I want to have good handstands. So I practice handstands for a minute every day. Can't you see I'm so in pain? Yes, I'm not, cause I don't talk and then you're right, need I forget. And I don't think you understand. So just, and you can do kind of a thousand affirmations during this too if you want. And I have it, so now it's gonna be a minute of stretching. I originally started this with a 6-minute routine. And this back here. So it was originally a 6-minute routine, and so I just added stretching because that was one thing that I thought was kind of missing from it. Even just a minute of regular stretches, you know, just if you have a specific part of your body that has problems, then you can work on that. Like I've been having issues with my shoulders, so I tend to do that. So I make sure my shoulders get a nice little stretch. It's not much, but it's something. Like that's kind of the idea of this. It's simple, like it's quick. It's a good thing, it's a good way for me to start my morning. It kind of gives me a little
meant to do more stuff. I find the days that I do this tend to be more productive overall.
Next is make bed or tidy up. I already made my bed. I'm staying at my friend Greg's house. Thanks for letting me crash here, Greg. So I already made the bed on the couch where I've been sleeping. And I'm pretty tidied up, but I guess I have a couple notebooks that aren't very tidy, so I'll make a nice little stack of that. I remember reading somewhere that the making bed is one of the habits that's common among successful people. There's a lot of different character traits that they thought would be common that weren't. You know, some people are messy, some people are more organized, some people are more introverted and extroverted and stuff, but they found in some study that people that made their bed every day, or successful people, almost always made their bed every day. And it's a kind of a way to order your day at the beginning. Next is going to be deep breaths. And I mix deep breaths and drinking water. So, I don't have my usual water bottle, so I'm just gonna use this glass. And I take deep breaths while I move, and I alternate it with drinking the water. Let's see if that'll stay there. So I'm gonna fill up some water while I'm filling it up. I take some deep breaths. I don't know if it's called forced breathing, but when I'm breathing in, I kind of swallow air into my lungs. And then I really breathe out and I try to really get my diaphragm fully out.
The world can be a nasty place. You know it, I know it, yeah. Put down the weapons you fight with, and kill them with kindness, kill them with kindness, kill them, kill them, kill them with kindness, kill them with kindness, kill them with kindness.
And I really try to fill up my whole lungs. Your lungs extend down into your back. Really, when you breathe in, try to fill up your whole lung capacity.
This should be the last minute. And I have this thankful book that my parents gave me for Christmas a long time ago. It was the same year that Chris Farley passed away, I remember. That's what I remember about that Christmas. So I have this book. And I just write down a few things I'm thankful for. Some of them get repeated, you know, in different forms fairly regularly. Like, you know, family and friends, that's a pretty common thing I'm thankful for, is they help me out with things. I'm thankful for YouTube today, because I haven't done that one in a while, and I'm glad that they provide the service so I can share this time with you guys. So I'm thankful for YouTube. I'm thankful for sunshine. That's a pretty normal one. Water and being hydrated. Okay, so that was the 8 minutes that Tabitha timer just went off. I'm not sure what's going to happen with the music here. I just get music on a radio station that plays and find something that you like, and I hope this helps, and I hope you guys try the